Okay, welcome back, everybody.
Welcome back, everyone. I was working on my mobi. I was trying to get the lights going. I was looking for an easy way to test the light bulbs without running the moped, but I don't have a 6-volt source. For 12-volt light bulbs, I usually have a 12-volt battery around, car battery or something, but I don't have a 6-volt source. And I thought of a device that I could actually make. I have this old variable AC to DC adapter that I was going to just wire some alligator clips to. And I think that would totally work because I can go 3 volts, 4.5, 6, 7.5, 9, even 12 volts with this. And then I thought, you know, there's probably something available. And sure enough, Amazon sells one. And I figured I would test it out. I'm still gonna make mine, but I figured I'd test this one out just to show you guys. Okay, this little power adapter was under 20 bucks. And it comes with all of this stuff. I mean, literally everything. But what I was really excited about was these alligator clips. All right, okay, there we go, plug it in. Oh, this one's nice. It goes all the way up to 24 volts and all the way down to 3. We can use this to test some stuff. Let's see. All right, there we go. That's 6, oh, that's 9 volts. It was 12, whoa, it's not a 12 volt. All right, so that's at 6 volts. That's kind of cool, so you know it works. Use this to like test your lights, figure out what's working, what's not. Let's see. All right, this one works. This is a 12 volt. Ooh, 19. The dial's a little tricky, but it works. That's kind of cool. You could use this to test all your stuff. I really like this thing. Well, this one, this is a dual filament. So it's kind of cool. You can check both sides. So this one, on this dual filament, one of the filaments is burned out. So that's kind of a cool test. So I'm gonna throw this one away. Let's see. Yeah, great. All right, so this thing works pretty good. I like it. I like that it's variable. I just thought of another really good use for this. You could use this for electrolysis. I think we should try that out. Get a bucket of water and some plastic, and I think you need about a tablespoon of baking soda per gallon of water. Do about half a tablespoon. I found this little weird clamp thing. This is pretty rusty. I think we could probably use this for an experiment. I used about half a tablespoon of baking soda to create the electrolyte mixture. All right, there we go. See if we can't suspend this off of this. And I'm gonna use this little thing for the anode. This is just a scrap piece of metal. I'm gonna attach the negative lead to the part, and I'm gonna attach the positive lead to the anode over here. I'm gonna plug these in. You can see all the rust bubbles. See all the bubbles coming up? That's how you know it's working. I'm gonna leave this for, I don't know, half an hour. Maybe I can turn the voltage down a little. It has been about 15 minutes and this stuff's changing colors. I'm gonna turn this thing off. I'm gonna disconnect this stuff. And I'm gonna go rinse this thing off and see what it looks like. I took the clamp out. It was only in there for maybe 15 minutes, but it took a lot of that surface rust off. If I left it in longer, I think it would take off some of the pitting. Now I'm gonna make my own. First thing I'm gonna do for this one is cut the end off. Just like that. And then I'm going to expand these wires a little bit and I'm going to strip them. Just like that. All right. Now I have to figure out which one is plus and which one is minus. I'm going to use my multimeter. I'm going to set it to DC. I'm using my multimeter. I'm setting it to DC. And now we can just test this out and it'll tell us if it's plus or minus. So that says 5.3. And so it does not have a minus next to it. So this is the correct. The one with the white stripe is positive. The one that's just black is negative. If I switch them around, you should see a negative pop up in the display. Yep, so the negative's over on the right. Now I'm gonna take these little alligator clips that I got from the hardware store. I'm basically gonna just splice these together. Okay, I have some shrink tubing I'm gonna use. And I have some longer shrink tubing I'm gonna use. I'm gonna slide the big one over these. And then I'm gonna slide the little one over the positive. Okay. Now I'm gonna twist these together, just like that. First I'm gonna dip these in some flux, like that, and heat this up. All right, that's pretty hot. All right, that one's good. I'm gonna twist this back like that. I'm gonna slide the shrink tubing over it, just like that. Now I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side, but on this side I'm not gonna use shrink tubing because I'm not worried about this side. There we go. Now on this side, I'm just gonna put it back like that, and I'm gonna do the other shrink tubing right over it like that. All right, there we go. I'm gonna clean this stuff up. Now I have my homemade benchtop variable DC power supply. We can plug it in, test it out. This thing's all over the place. My settings are a little weird. Right here, I've got it set to 3 volts and I've got 5.3. Now it's set to 4.5 volts and I got 7.1. 6 volts is 9.3. 7.5 volts is 11.6. 9 volts is 14 volts. And 12 volts is 19 volts. So this one's a little off, but I think it'll work just fine for me. I'll just have to make a new little gauge for this. We can set it for 11.6 and test some 12 volt stuff. Got this guy out of here. So, I got these backwards. So that works just the same. So I can use this one and I can, you know, ramp it up, see what different voltages are gonna look like with this light. The main thing that I'm gonna be using this for is just testing to see if things actually work or not. So if it's not perfect voltage, it really shouldn't matter too much, just as long as I can test if they work or not. This device was under 20 bucks, super handy. I made this one because I already had it and I don't use it for anything else, so I figured why not make my own. If you have one of these, you can totally make one yourself. Otherwise, you can buy one pretty cheap. I think it's gonna come in handy when I'm trying to troubleshoot if light bulbs are burnt out or if they work or not. Let me know what y'all think, if something like this would be useful on your bench.